guys.
So, we were going to do this yesterday, but...
My hair's all fluffy.
We,
had a impromptu date night thingy.
Yes. So...
We actually went to... we finally saw Suicide Squad.
Yes.
So, I'm happy. Joker's sexy. I'm sorry.
That was an awesome movie. We liked it.
Joker and Harley. I love who they got to play Harley.
Yeah.
She was awesome.
So, anyways... Went yesterday and picked up our pre-order of the Sun and Moon Collector's Edition Strategy Guide. This thing is gorgeous. You seriously have to see it in person. I mean, it is gorgeous. I love how it looks.
This originally released alongside the Sun and Moon games, but our GameStop got them like a week or two late.
Yeah.
So... Matt was able to pick it up yesterday.
And apparently, since we had gotten both games, we pre-ordered both games. We were supposed to get a poster with it when we picked them up, but we didn't. So, it's a double-sided poster. So there's that side. And the other side, map of Alola.
Wobbles is hyper. This is a nice, like, heavy-duty...
Yes, it is.
It's really nice.
It's a nice heavy-duty...
We could actually put that up there where my drawings used to be.
Yeah.
I think that would be a good thing. My hair is, like, floofy, and
right
it's...
Right next to our Mega Deancey.
Yeah.
So, open this.
Waffles!
Looks like they might have an easy open in the back, maybe. And the guide, this is the collector's edition, so it is $40.
What does it say on the...
Collector's edition official Alola Region Strategy Guide includes high quality lithograph set and bonus section of concept artwork. That's Ooh. Just with the collector's edition.
This thing is gorgeous. It's like...
It is. It's textured.
Yeah, it's textured and shiny and pretty.
Let's get that off. Okay, so.
Ooh.
So here's the back of it. It's just a little... That's supposed to be the back of the guide. But since this is the collector's edition, here's the actual back for the collector's edition.
They should make a system like this. That would be gorgeous.
This is gorgeous. So they put this insert in so you can read the details while it's wrapped up and everything.
You can see a little bit how that is. And like up close, you can see the stars and...
So it says, for the guide, see how to complete trials to unlock powerful Z moves. What's he getting into?
Probably the plastic.
Come on, baby.
He's trying to steal my brownie!
He's trying to take your brownie.
You little bastard! Get over here! That is Mama's brownie. He's like, I'm a fight for the brownie.
Fight for your right to eat a brownie.
No. Come here. Hi! I'm being bad. Hi.
It says, the lush islands.
I don't think they've ever actually gotten acquainted with Waffles. He's like, I see myself. You see that? Okay, sorry.
Get ready for adventure in the Alola region. The lush islands of the Alola region are teeming with new Pokemon, people, and places to discover. Prepare for adventures, new ways to partner with Pokemon, and many surprises along the way. See how to complete trials to unlock powerful Z moves. Learn how to train for battles and take on friends in a four-way battle royale. Find out about missions and other fun activities in Festival Plaza. It says whether you choose Pokemon Sun or Pokemon Moon, get the most out of your journey with this official strategy guide that will help you explore a Pokemon game unlike any that's come before. Inside you'll find detailed walkthrough of your main adventure, Pokemon list to help you fill your Alola Pokedex, the scoop on new moves, new items, and more, info on special challenges and side quests for rare items, intros to new gameplay features like the Pokéfinder and Poképelago. Is that right? Pelago?
I keep calling it Pelago.
Pelago?
I don't know how it's pronounced. It's P-E-L-A-G-O. I call it Pelago.
It probably is Pelago.
It's a little island thing that you can...
Yeah, since it's more of like a Hawaiian...
I call it Pelago.
I was going more for like Italian.
Are you in the mood for pasta? Actually, that does sound good.
Yeah, pasta sounds good. Pasta.
Homer wants us to put on pants.
Guides to online features and competitions for hours of additional fun. And you get a bonus pull-out map showing every island in the region. And it's a official Alola region poster map.
Which is the poster or...
No, it comes with... Okay, these are the... Concept art comes in this little folder. This is awesome.
This is a pretty blue.
Oh, and I like this. It has a little caution. Some images may contain game spoilers. Ooh. So we're not going to show the images.
Yeah. I'm not going to look at the images until I beat the game.
Yeah, we'll probably save those for later.
Sorry, guys.
Those are... Kinda
we could do how Jimbo.
Bit. I think that's just concept art.
We could do how Jimbo did on South Park when they were showing like the tree iPhone. Oh. Just like show it like, okay, this is this. I don't know what it is. Waffles might be in that.
And then we got a little insert. Take your game to the next level.
Stop sharing on plastic.
Pokemon Sun and Pokemon Moon, the official Alola Region Pokedex and post-game adventure guide.
Those are the other two of that bird.
Oh, she just found out something. This will be available early 2017. It'll have a post-game guide for the adventures awaiting you, data for the Alola Region Pokemon, exclusive creator interview, helpful info on each Pokemon's moves, ability, location, stats, and evolutions, and lists of TMs, items, berries, and Z crystals, including where to find them.
See, this little birdie right here, that's what I figured. It's one bird, but apparently you give it different types of nectar, and it changes its form. I've seen this one and this one. I haven't seen that one yet. That's cool.
And then on the back of this insert. So, that's cool. That's the other one that I'm wanting to get the post-game. Pokedex.
Is that another guide? Is that what it said?
It's a...
A post-game guide.
Yeah, it's a post-game adventure guide. They do it with every game. They put out like a nice... strategy guide to go with the game and then a post-game guide.
I've played like just about every Pokemon game. I've never
gotten the guides. And the back cover is the map. I figured it'd be in either the front or back cover. This is nice. This is a nice heavy...
Like the same cardstock? Yeah.
Yeah, about. So, the Alola region map... I got it, baby.
I want to touch it, too. I can, like, see.
Here, baby.
Well, what? Did I not do it good enough? And then,
on the other side is a type matchup chart.
Yeah, I was just looking at that.
So, if you have troubles remembering all the type matchups...
Like you.
Well, they've added a lot since, you know...
Yeah, because, like, the one I ended up picking was the owl.
Rowlet.
Rowlet. It's a grass and ghost type.
Grass and ghost type.
Someone wonder traded me a Litten.
Oh. Huh.
Yeah.
Good for you.
Yes.
I don't have to breed you one.
Yeah, because you're not going to breed me one for, like, another 2 years, because you're not going to play for, like, another 2 years.
Huh. play.
Yeah, for like another 2 years. You'll play when the next game comes out.
You'll play when the next game comes out.
I'll play the next game when the next game comes out. That's what happened.
This is gorgeous. So.
Oh, this is cool. It has very effective, non-effective, normal damage, and no effect. That's another thing I liked in the Sun and Moon game is when you face a Pokemon, the next time you come across it, it'll tell you which moves are most effective, non-effective, has no effect, and everything. So that was really cool.
Yeah, I like that too. Hey. Get away from there.
Waffles wants to play.
Brownie alone.
Is he trying to take my brownie again? Waffles? I will feed you to the nutcracker. Do we have a nutcracker? I don't think we have a nutcracker. He doesn't know that. You stop being mischievous. Come on. Come attack Daddy. Come attack Daddy.
Did that right. But,
what the hell?
Here's the inside.
What the hell? What is that?
Execute.
What?
That's an execute. That's the Alola form.
What the hell did they do to execute? They freaking...
This is the first time she's seen the Alola form of execute.
What did they do to it? It never had a neck before, let alone a freaking 10-foot tall neck. What did they
do? It's a palm tree now.
Why? You don't take an egg Pokemon and make it into like a freaking giraffe palm tree thingy. What the hell? What is that? Oh, look at that one. I only ended up finding, like, a small amount of Pokemon. I keep finding, like, the same 10 Pokemon no matter where I go and how many times I try to expand my Pokedex. So, I haven't seen a lot of the new things.
And then in the back cover, they have some more.
So you know what's funny?
I like that.
When you find him, you know, he's like a little, I can't remember what he's called. But he's like a little crab Pokemon. You find him in berries, he attacks you. It was like nowhere near water or anything, he just randomly attacks. That's the one that... Does that one have a... Is that a sand glob with a shovel sticking in it? The freaking little... This little... Okay, this little guy evolves into something called Beware. This is that crushes your spines. He's trying to kill this little sand Pokemon by shoving a shovel in its brain. You see how terrified that thing is? Look at that! The poor thing! Wait, I'm looking at this.
Maybe. You can look at it after the video.
No. This is your fault for not letting me look at it before the video. Who's that?
Okay.
Like, I'm asking you, like, you know.
Concept art. Oh, cool. They put the concept art in the front of the book as well.
Oh, so the ones in there are just, like, the cardstock of the...
Yeah.
So that's cool. See,
they gave us, like, two of it.
Hmm.
And they still put the...
May contain...
Yeah.
So the spoilers for that would be, like, I think... Here.
Yeah, right there. Thank you. So then, here's the first page, the official Alola region strategy guide.
Table of contents.
Yeah, nice.
That's a lot.
Nice table of contents.
285 pages.
Article index, quick location guide, how to register in the island Pokedexes. And it lists all the Pokemon in here. Well, probably not all of them, but probably all of them that they have in the game. This is probably all of them that they have within the games, within the two games combined.
Oh, there's another of the Alola map.
Yeah. Here's the map on the inside. Got the guide. Little intro, welcome to the world, Pokemon.
So, playing more through the game, I don't think you're related to the professor. It's kind of like, you know how a lot of people from Hawaii call people cousins as like a...
Yeah, they did it in the, he did that in the, demo. I'm currently playing through the demo of it. I'm trying to get the, timed items. You have to wait like a certain number of days to get another item.
But when we first like started up, it said, "Hey, cousin," yeah, and that was like very confusing.
We thought that you were related to the professor, which would be cool. I mean, come on. Yeah. Here, what are Pokemon?
It looks like it gives a little bit info about the startup. Yes.
So if you're a beginner.
Oh, look at the little sand shrew. See? What?
What I was saying is, so if you're a beginner and you, like, this is your first Pokemon game, you can get the guide and kind of get caught up on, you know, everything. It goes
not
into
really the story about everything, yeah, but the like the kind of technical
like,
things.
Yeah, the technical things, like what Pokemon are and, you know, evolution and learning moves and whatnot.
Look at the little Sandshrew. Oh, look at the Sandslash. Look. Wait, I
want to
show
you. Oh, okay. And then it shows this page that she's going to show you. Shows the Sun and Moon exclusive Pokemon. So it looks like there's 12 in each game.
Wait, Grubbin evolves into that, but Rockruff has two forms of evolution.
It depends on which game you get. You see that?
Okay. I'm having trouble finding a Rockruff anyways. So I will get that version.
Which looks more like a werewolf.
He looks cool. Like when I saw him in battle.
It's just two
different.
Midnight
form.
It's the same Pokemon, just two different forms. Because they're both Lycanroc.
Yeah, but it says if you evolve, from what I've seen, if you evolve Rockruff during the day, it'll have this form. If you evolve him during the night, it'll have this form.
I think it's
it may be game exclusive.
It may be game exclusive, because it does.
It says midday form and then the game symbol.
The game symbol. So I think it's
possibly a game exclusive.
Game exclusive. So it's possible, kind of like the Mega Evolutions for Charizard in X and Y.
Or the Mew.
They had
Mewtwo, you know.
Yeah, Mewtwo, sorry. They had two different ones, depending on which game you got. I think that's how that one is.
Orangaroo. Look at the Drampa. It looks like that that dragon from, what is it, Neverending Story?
Hmm.
You see it?
Mm-hmm.
Anyways, what we were talking about is Rockruff, right here. It may be game exclusive for Sun and then Moon. It also says midday and midnight evolutions. And
then on this page, it shows the exclusive Pokemon that you can find in either version. So there's 12 in each game. So I like that it's an even number so that, you know, it makes trading a little easier.
The nature of time is quite different in Alola compared to other regions. If you're playing Pokemon Sun, when it's daytime in the real world, it'll also be daytime in Alola. However, if you're playing Pokemon Moon, it will instead be nighttime in Alola when it's daytime in the real world. This is important because certain Pokemon only appear during the day or night in some areas, and certain activities can only be accomplished during the day and night as well. Daytime-only activities are marked by a special icon throughout this guide with the sun. While nighttime-only activities are denoted by a different icon, which is the moon. So that actually answers one of the things we were wondering. Remember how during the day when I play, it's night in the game?
Yeah.
And I was wondering if that had any actual significance throughout the thing, remember?
Yeah.
He's warming up my toes.
Menus and options. So it goes through all of the menus and options that you can go through. The battle screen. And then you get to walk through itself. First page. Understanding this walkthrough. So, If there's a ride Pokemon needed, it'll tell you which Pokemon you need.
Don't show me that. I think I still have some to discover. That's one of the things I was wanting to, like, try to avoid telling you is, Oh, did you already know that they took out the HMs in the game?
I did not know about that.
That's what the ride Pokemon are. That's what I was...
Okay.
Because, this kind of does, like, strength.
Yeah, because it smashes the rocks.
Yeah, this one was, it sniffs out hidden items. Remember, like, that one?
Nice.
Surf. For Lapras.
And probably Waterfall as well.
I haven't come across Waterfall. Not sure if they have it in the game.
They may not have waterfalls in the game. I know that's...
I know they have actual waterfalls in the game, but not if you can go up them. This one takes you over the rough terrain. Like, you know, the rocky things that you normally wouldn't be able to pass over.
Okay.
Don't know and don't know.
Tauros would be Rock Smash.
That's what I meant.
Machamp would probably be Strength.
I said Strength, didn't I? Yeah.
Anyways. items and shop lists. And of course, I like the guides because they give you little tips down here. They'll give you like little tip boxes. Recommended route. So they give you a recommended route to, on where to go next.
One of the things I do like in the game is when, like, if you don't play for a few days or a few months, and you pick it back up, it'll tell you where you're supposed to go. Like, it'll have, like, a obvious icon on your story objective or something that you're supposed to do next.
They have a sub-event list. And, it tells you the conditions to do it.
Oh, and also...
Like, after getting a fishing rod or...
There's some things that have the...
After completing something...
Yeah, there's some things that are game exclusive. You see that?
And then it says if it's game exclusive or not. And then it gets into the guide.
This is a really big guide.
It gets into the guide. Here, baby. Let me see.
It's funny, the villains in this game are Team Skull, which I think is the same in both games. Instead of how, like, Ruby and Sapphire had Team Aqua and Team Magma, you know?
Yeah. And then this chunk right here is the guide.
Like, from, the walkthrough of the game?
Yeah, the whole walkthrough. It's, from the beginning of your adventure. Hold on, baby, hold on.
I wanted to see how many pages it was. 21 to 216.
Yeah.
Almost 200 pages worth. What are you looking at me like that for?
But it's,
You see him? He's down here warming my toes like, why are you not giving me attention?
But this is from when you start the game to when you defeat the Elite Four. And then it has an after becoming champion section for things to do... Things for a champion to do in Alola. So everything that you... So a lot of things that you can do post-game...
I still can't believe what they did to Execute. They, like, took his neck and went, shh.
And then they have an advanced trainer handbook.
Well, those are all the stamps you get for when you complete the challenge.
Complete your trainer passport.
I've seen in some of the Pokemon groups how people only, like, have, like, their passport half full and couldn't figure out what to do after to get the rest of the pages full. So this will tell you what to do.
Yeah, this will tell you what to do.
Because it...
Yeah, it shows all the stamps. It
tells
you how to obtain each and every one of them.
What are you looking at?
become an expert of Pokemon battling, mastering type matchups.
Yeah, this is something I thought was funny. Grass is strong against water in this game, right here. You see that? Because my rival chose Piplio, or Poplio. I keep calling it Piplio.
You mean water's...
No, right here, see? Attacks with leafage, 3x damage. Against the water.
Yeah.
In the earlier games, it's usually like water against fire, fire against thing, and then
fucking clicked on there for you, didn't it?
Fuck you. I've never had the grass Pokemon before. Leave me alone. It's just something like I thought it didn't click in my head. Okay, because I'm used to having the fire Pokemon. So when I first started, I was used, like, my mind thought I had the fire Pokemon, so it didn't seem right that I was strong against the water, okay? Because throughout my entire little Pokemon career, it was always fire. So, except with the little penguin Pokemon.
Yeah.
I've never...
Piplup.
Yeah, Piplup. So, I've never Piplup. Had the grass Pokemon. I've never had the grass starter.
So this is the first for you.
Yes. So that's why, in my mind, it was so odd for me to be strong against the water.
And then they have a thing for berries. Reduces super effective damage from, tells you the berry type and what damage it reduces.
That's one of the things, the Pokelego thingy. The first island in it is where you get more beans to feed your Pokemon from. And also, like, you use, like, beans to unlock the other little islands. But one of them you use to grow more berries.
Nice.
Yes.
And then it also has a little section for abilities that affect damage. So they list that.
Oh, well, like water
absorb. Like water absorb restores HP. water absorb restores HP when hit by a water type move instead of taking damage.
How does thick fat help reduce the damage taken from fire? It says reduce damage taken from fire and ice type Pokemon, but from fire? Like, fire melts fat, okay? We know that anyone who cooks meat.
Yeah.
It sounds...
But it would melt the fat. It wouldn't really hurt the Pokemon that much. If you think of it that way.
Yeah, but to get to the fat, they have to go through all the nerve endings in the skin. That would hurt.
No, the fat's on the outside.
No. No, it's not. okay, see, all the fat under the skin is not on the outside of the skin. It doesn't work that way.
Held items that increase damage. So it lists the held items and the type of move that it boosts. Type immunities. Be a move expert. Leveling up. Evolving. TMs.
I have not seen that Pokemon before.
You haven't seen Hakamo'o?
Hakamo'o? No, I haven't.
He was in the demo, so...
No, I haven't seen him.
Yeah, you haven't played the demo. That was the one that was, like, featured all throughout.
Kiss my paw.
Oh.
You're supposed to kiss it. You see how offended he looked? You got little crusties in your eye.
Let's see here. TMs, Madam Memorial, Move Tutors.
Was that Zelda trying to get in the room?
I don't know. Egg moves, Evolution Cancel... Know how to use your moves.
You know, the daycare in this, it's not really a daycare. You know how in previous games when you leave your Pokemon there and you walk around and everything trying to, for people trying to do the Masada effect thingy to breed shiny Pokemon, you know how they train them and level them up?
Mm-hmm.
Not in this game.
I kind of like that.
Yeah, they just watch after your Pokemon. They don't... It's not really a daycare. They kind of explain it a little bit when you come across it. And you actually come across it pretty early in the game.
Oh, I like that.
I think either on the first or second island. So you come across it pretty early in the game.
That's good.
Yeah.
I like that.
Yeah.
And I like that it doesn't level up your Pokemon.
Yeah, I do too, because...
I like that. That's why I never really use the daycares.
Yeah, because he likes leveling them up for, like, certain
moves. Certain moves.
Yeah.
I want to make sure that my Pokemon get certain moves before they evolve, if they do evolve.
And also, like, sometimes when you leave a low level in there to try to breed for something and you're walking around a lot, before you know it, they could reach level 100. And if you wanted to evolve that specific Pokemon, you're kind of screwed right there.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Let's see here. So, moves can inflict status conditions.
We're already at 30 minutes. Yeah. I did not notice that.
Moves can help give your Pokemon advantage, see stat changes, goes through all the moves, different types of things there, gets into the Z moves.
Well, that's pretty. I don't know what Pokemon that is, but that's pretty, yeah. Waffles is like...
Abilities, hidden abilities, using items wisely... Mastered the art of the combo. So nice little tips for battling. Building a balanced team. Battle royales. Catching the right Pokemon.
There's the Alola Raichu. The Alola Raichu is adorable. If you put it to sleep, it actually falls asleep hovering on its tail.
Aww.
It's adorable. It is so cute.
It has a section on trading.
Okay.
Island scan. Training the most powerful Pokemon.
I'm so sad that they...
Eevee's evolutionary advantages.
Yeah. They did not put a freaking new Eeveelution.
They go over species strengths.
There's that beware. That freaky bear Pokemon.
Nature. Individual strengths tip.
Well, it shows you, like, the differences.
Okay. Yeah. Let's see,
Meow.
Oh, this is giving you an example of Pikachu with an ill-suited nature. Poor individual strengths and everything, so...
How natures affect the...
Yeah. Because they're stats. Showing one Pikachu... They're both level 100... They're showing one with a special attack at 94 and the other with a special attack at 218.
It says, take two Pikachu both ways up to level 100 from hours of play. A Pikachu with an ill-suited nature, poor individual strength, and no base stat training or special attack might end up with a special attack of 94. A Pikachu with the right nature... What is the right nature for a Pikachu?
I don't know.
With the right nature, the best individual strengths and math base stats might have a special attack stat of 218. Which one do you think stands better chance of winning a battle?
Yeah. So they go into the natures of Pokemon.
I do like that explains more about the natures of Pokemon because up until now it's kind of been really confusing for me.
They go into individual strengths and base stats. Characteristics, hyper training,